Hi, this is Mark Battis from Battis Financial. Today we're going to talk about what to consider with your finances when you get married. Marriage marks a significant milestone in life, blending not only two individuals, but also their financial landscape. If you're planning to tie the knot soon, or if you've recently gotten married, consider these 29 planning issues. They'll help you pave the way to a secure and harmonious future. This checklist covers a variety of issues you should consider in the following categories. First is cash flow. So for example, have you and your partner created a joint budget that considers both your financial obligations and goals? Now, a question I get asked a lot is, do we need to merge all our accounts together and all our funds together? And no, the answer is no. You can do things how you want if you want to keep things separately, but you should have a joint budget that takes both of your financial situations into account and both of your joint obligations into account as well. There's also asset and debt related issues. So for example, have you and your partner decided how assets acquired prior to and during marriage will be owned, managed, titled? There are insurance things to consider. For you, for example, have you and your partner evaluated the health insurance options that you now have, being that you're both married? Does it make sense to merge and go under one plan or maintain separate policies? There are estate planning things to consider. Have you and your partner updated beneficiary designations on retirement accounts, life insurance policies? Do you need life insurance now that maybe someone is dependent upon your income? There are tax planning things to consider. Have you determined the most advantageous tax filing status for your situation? It could still be married filing jointly. There's a single tax filing status, but now you're married. You have to decide married filing separately, married filing jointly, head of household. Have you explored the potential tax deductions, tax credits that are available to married couples? On our website every year, we link to a key financial data card that has updated information around different details of tax brackets. There's also retirement and other longer term planning things to consider. So for example, have you updated your plans to reflect both of your goals and timelines? Have you run a projected retirement scenario now? Are you contributing enough to your retirement plans when you take both of your goals, both of your finances into account? The checklist, it also covers other financial items such as prenuptial agreements, custody, support, healthcare directives. You can download the full checklist at battisfinancial.com/marriage checklist. Navigating these financial planning issues together is definitely something that'll set you up or to strengthen your relationship. To look at it on the negative side, money and finances are in the top two reasons why marriages dissolve or people get divorced. So you definitely want to get started on the strong suit. And even if you're not recently married, it's a good idea to kind of think about or take a look at a lot of these planning items. Some of them will be relevant, some of them will be not applicable, but one way to find out is to go through and evaluate and determine if it's something that you should be thinking about or should be taking action on. So we're committed to guiding people through these life-changing events like a marriage, like starting a family. We invite you to schedule a complimentary consultation as you embark on this exciting journey. You can do that at battisfinancial.com/call.